Hi everyone, Johnny here with another griddle video. Today we're making shredded hash browns on the Camp Chef flat top grill. I had not done these yet on the griddle, so I did them three different ways to see which was best. And let's see how they turned out. These are just frozen shredded hash browns. I'll do another video for fresh hash browns at some point. The frozen ones are really good though and relatively easy to make. The only way you really mess them up is to burn them because your heat is too high, or if you touch them too much and move them around, then you don't get that crispy brown skin. I did both of those things in this cook, so hopefully you can learn from my mistakes when you're making hash browns at home. First thing I did is preheated the griddle on medium, which was my first mistake. It was way too high. The Camp Chef runs hot, so medium is like 400 to 425 degrees. It might be different for a Blackstone. You might be good on medium, but you need it like 350, 375 tops. So that's why mine got a little bit too dark. And the ones that turned out the best were the ones that were all the way on the right, because that fourth burner was off. So that section of the griddle was probably a little bit warmer, probably closer to 350, which is perfect. I put down some oil, spread it around. I did find out you probably can't be too shy with the oil. It really doesn't hurt to have it a decent amount down so that these don't get too dark and burnt, and also so you get them up off there. So don't be worried about putting down a little bit of oil to get the color you want on these bad boys. So the first thing I did is one of them had a lid on, the one in the middle had nothing, and the one on the right had my bacon press slash smash burger panini press weight on it. The one with the lid on I did because that's exactly what the instructions on the frozen potato bag said to do if you're doing it in a skillet. I only got this clear lid for a pot. I don't have a dome yet, but any lid will work. So I kind of wanted to see how that would work with steaming them while they cook. That also, though, ended up being the hottest part of the griddle, as you'll see when I flip things over. The ones in the middle turned out well, except for they didn't really hold together as I flipped them. They kind of fell apart. And then the ones all the way on the right with the panini slash bacon pressed, well, they ended up actually being the best ones. It really kind of pressed down the hash browns into the griddle, made them all stick together, made them have a clean, more surface area touch the hot griddle. So it really got that nice, like crispy, golden brown, diner style hash brown look that you want. So I did them for about 6 minutes on each side. They got burnt, and I don't think it was too long because they still wouldn't have been done if I would have done them shorter. It was just my griddle was too high. So if you're going to do these in the future, my recommendation to you is make sure you know the temp of your griddle. If you have a thermometer, use that. Get it around 350. If you don't have a thermometer, I just start low and be patient with it. You can use a lid to help steam them as well, but if you got any sort of weight, that seemed to work out very, very well for me. The weight really made a nice diner style crispy hash brown, and don't touch them too much. Just don't be playing with the hash browns. I see a lot of people that like to just like mix them up and stuff, and that doesn't get you what your desired outcome is, which is a thin layer of crispy shredded hash browns. Well, I hope you liked this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please hit subscribe and like. As always, have a good one and keep on cooking.